Good morning, Discoverers!
We miss you! Today, we're going to sing, first of all, our good morning song. Miss Tyler and me are happy to talk to you today because Miss Raven is out today.
Yes.
And Miss Fran. So I'm so happy I got to see you guys. Let's do our good morning song.
Good morning,
Discoverers. How do you do?
Good morning, Discoverers. We miss you.
Yay! Let's do it. Today we're going to do about we're going to study environment. Environment is very important. It's the land and the air we breathe and the water around us. And all our homes are in our environment. Okay, and environment is everything that is in echo. Echo is a short word to ecology and learning about our environment.
Yes.
Yes. So Ms. Tyler and me are gonna show you about our habitats. The desert is very dry. The Arctic, very cold. A pond is very, very nice and cooling. And the seashore, who doesn't like to go to the seashore? It's beautiful. And the woodland is all the forest. And the meadow is the little hills and little places that we like. They're green and beautiful. And let's learn who lives in each habitat. All right, let's go to the animals on the farm. Who lives on the farm? Pig lives on the farm. So we're gonna put the pig is in the farm. And chicken lives in the farm. And who lives in the farm? This is it. Pig, chicken, and a horse. And a pig lives in the farm. Let's see. Who lives now in the zoo? Let's put them back. Let's see. Who lives in the zoo? How about giraffe lives in the zoo? Isn't it, Miss Tyler?
Yes.
And who else? Do you think elephant live in,
yeah,
in the zoo?
Yeah, of course.
How about zebra?
Yeah, and we talked about zebras last week.
Yeah, and all stripy and nice. How about lion?
Yes.
How about kangaroo?
Yes.
How about animals in the ocean? Do you think the crab lives in the ocean?
Yes.
Yeah. How about a fish?
Yes.
How about a puffer fish?
Yes.
Yeah. How about a turtle? It lives in the pond,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes.
And a frog too, don't forget. And the frog says, ribbit, 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 ribbit.
Yes.
And We are really happy to tell you that all our animals and reptiles and insects that lives in the ecosystem are very happy to live in a clean air. But when we're around animals, especially zoo animals and wild animals, we have to be very careful and leave distance between us. Even when we go to the zoo, we like to keep distance. That's why we have a lot of fences in the zoo. And when we go to the pond and see the frogs, we don't go jump in the pond unless our parents are next to us. We can watch what's going on in the pond, the fish and the frogs. And when we go to the ocean, we can splash and look at the sea and play a lot of games around it and made some sand castles. And you know who else lives in the sea? Fish and crab and pufffish. And the turtle lives in the pond, of course.
Yes.
All right, guys.
Okay, and so also, we forgot to mention what they have in their habitat. So what animals need for their habitat, they need food and water, they need shelter, a mate for reproduction, and oxygen from the air. Cool. So what plants need from their habitat is light, water, carbon dioxide from the air, and minerals from the soil. That's cool too. And animals and plants are adapted to survive in their own habitat. So to survive in the Arctic, like the polar bear up here where it's cold, cool. You will need thick hairy coat and a layer of blubber to prevent heat escaping. You will need fur for camouflage and is a strong swimmer and runner to catch food. And you also need big feet to spread its weight on snow or ice. And then to survive in the desert, is it the desert on here? Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah, the desert, as a cactus, you need long roots to absorb the water deep underground. You need a thick fleshy stem to store water and a thick waxy coating to stop the water from evaporating, and has a sharp spine to stop the other things from eating it. That is a lot, and that is so cool. Habitats, we all need habitats. We all have a habitat. For instance, your habitat would be your bedroom.
Your home?
Yes.
And maybe your backyard?
Yes.
And you know what? Sometimes it's your school.
Yes.
And we love to see you. Hopefully you enjoyed our class today.
Yes.
As we enjoyed presenting it to you.
Yes.
And we'll see you soon.
And we miss you guys.
We miss you guys.
So bye, Discoverers.
Bye, Discoverers.